give you your own bottle of alcohol spray. You get into a vehicle, every single vehicle will have a spray bottle of alcohol spray. There's alcohol spray everywhere, and they spray everything. They spray the silverware, they spray the handles on cars, steering wheels, the stick shifter, your cell phone. Everything gets sprayed by alcohol. It's unbelievable. Everyone is like crazy about cleanliness here. People are so detail-oriented when it comes to sanitation in here. And I'm not just talking about in hotels, I'm talking about you walk down the street, every woman has a huge spray bottle in her purse full of alcohol, and they spray everything that they touch, or everything, or their hands after they've touched anything. Guy has a whole truckload full of ginger root. So here people coming into the church are being disinfected with alcohol sprayed by the nun. And she's checking their temperature too before they go into the church. So I'm just sitting here in the Plaza Grande, just watching life go on a Sunday afternoon, and people are out enjoying the day as normal. Quite bizarre though, because usually you see a lot of tourists around here in the historic center going to all of the museums and the cathedrals and going into little handicraft shops, and I'm really the only one. Quite nice. I've had quite a few people come and give me the thumbs up and say thank you for coming to Ecuador. It's good to see visitors again. So yeah, that feels good. That's the Super Mario theme.
El jefe.
Buenas.
¿Cómo estás?
Hola, Claire. ¿Cómo estás?
I'm up here on the rooftop terrace of Casa Gangotena, and I'm with Juan David, who is the hotel manager.
Thank you very much, Clark, for visiting us. We are located here in Plaza San Francisco. In 1917, the Russo brothers, they were commissioned to build this beautiful mansion by the owners, the Gangotena family, one of the wealthiest and more important families here in Ecuador. They managed to build each room with a different sense and different beauty, and I'm going to show you around. It took more or less 5 years to turn the house into a hotel. Right now we are in the former sewing room, where all the ladies in the society used to come here and talk, gossip around what happened in Quito. This one also one of the original bathrooms in the house. Well, now we're here in the former dining room. When the Gangotena family moved into the mansion, there were just 5 Gangotenas, and they have more than 50 servants in the house. So let's say it's like Downtown Abbey here in Quito. We are waiting for you. We're gonna make sure that you're gonna have a beautiful experience with us. So welcome to Casa Gangotena if you decide to come.
So it's about 10:30 on Sunday night, and I'm just waiting for the driver to pick me up and take me to the airport. Right on time. I think that's my guy. He's actually 6 minutes early. These vehicles, they take biosecurity pretty seriously. They say they use much larger vehicles than normal, so I mean, I have this entire bus, 12 people to myself, and if you look, the driver is actually behind plexiglass too. You hear me, Connor? Coming back to Zuleta. I'm at the airport. It's time to switch up to the pro mask. Just to get in the airport, they're like metering. It's almost like that metering system, like on ramps on the freeway, letting people in so they're not crowding in. Again, alcohol spray on everyone's hands before they walk into the airport, making sure everyone has a mask on before the end of the airport. Pretty thorough.
some people take it too far.
Welcome to Ecuador. You can visit here a lot of places. It's a safe place to do tourism here. You are welcome.
See, even the immigration people on board, he wanted me to film him and send a message to everybody.
So I'm in the VIP lounge in the Quito airport. Just been kind of thinking and reflecting on this trip. A couple takeaways I have from it is that I'm leaving feeling super optimistic for Ecuador and for tourism. I see a bright future. You know, if Ecuador manages things like this, I think that tourists start to come in and experience this and start spreading the word, more and more people are gonna come here. What's been really refreshing being here is that everybody's on board. Everyone taking it seriously. You actually hear Ecuadorians speaking positively about the steps they've taken. Also just refreshing seeing that there's actually a national response and every citizen is like on the same page in terms of if we're gonna get through this and we're gonna get our economy going again and we're gonna get tourism going again, we all need to take this seriously and everyone is. I talked about before even leaving about this concept of like a shared experience. It's just getting out of my own bubble and out of my own country and coming to another country and really speaking with so many people about their firsthand experience of going through this pandemic. So it's just made the whole, like, this global pandemic for me more real of a global pandemic and less about what my situation is at home. I've had it extremely, extremely easy. You know, and another thing too is that I haven't been watching the news for a week. I'm well aware that at the moment in the United States, the news has been all about that cases are spiking and Europe might be closing down again, but just being away from that, been a real tonic for the mind and the soul just to be out of that. Reminded me to look back in my Instagram post, the last international trip, I was in Montreal, Quebec, March 13th when everything kicked off, and this is what I wrote, and it's amazing how true it is. Art is powerful and speaks to us at the right time. Due to canceled meetings, I had spent the better part of the morning holed up in a hotel room 22 floors above Montreal, fixated on my laptop screen, sucked into doom and gloom scenarios and panic. I felt sweaty, dizzy, on the verge of a panic attack. I layered up and took a long walk in the freezing rain and wind around a slate-gray Montreal. But people were going about life, and life was going about them. I had reached a mental state of not thinking about the decimated travel industry or coronavirus at all. I was trying to decipher signs in French and loving the wind in my face. When this bronze piece of art statue of a man hunched over a laptop, looking frenzied, worried, and appearing to sweat from the raindrops dripping off his chin, stopped me in my tracks. This was me an hour ago. It reminded me to deal with what is going on right now, practically. Don't get sucked into a frenzy by the digital world and the news cycle. If you are feeling overwhelmed, go take a walk outside, get some fresh air, and exercise. It's always the best medicine. So now, on my next international trip 7 months later, still in this pandemic, this trip has been exactly that for me. It's gotten me out of that just crazy frenzy, focusing on day to day, looking after myself. You know, the travel took my mind off of it, but it also made me really appreciate, and maybe better appreciate this time that we're going through, what it is and what we can learn from it about ourselves and the world around us by engaging with it and not letting it completely control me. Okay, so I'm boarded my flight Quito to Houston, and it's about 90% full. Again, another surprise, a lot of people traveling, and I've got a whole row to myself. But the seat doesn't recline.